Okay, so let's move on to the next question. And the question has to do with a recent study that claimed microwaving broccoli was able to increase levels of sulforaphane in the broccoli.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that study?
Rhonda, I don't like being negative about other people's studies, but I don't like it. so respectfully, you know, I think they said a number of things that are misleading, maybe not wrong, but they sort of get you down the wrong garden path to truth. So first of all, when you harvest broccoli sprouts or broccoli, you or a farmer, they don't have any sulforaphane in them. They don't have any free sulforaphane. It's all glucoraphanin, which is the precursor of sulforaphane. Myrosinase converts one to the other. Happens when you start chewing. It happens in your gut. We've talked about that. Microwaving is merely a gentle method by which one cooks, and you can try to minimize denaturing or destruction of myrosinase with microwaving, and there's evidence that there's, you know, you may not completely wipe out the myrosinase if you don't get the internal temperature of the food product up above 70 or 80 degrees centigrade Celsius. Microwaving also gives you minimal leakage of plant juice. So, you know, when you steam the hell out of something or boil a vegetable, you know, most of the goodies come out in the wash. They come out in the pot liquor, right? Yeah. So microwaving is useful there. But they state, don't have it in front of me, they state something like increase the levels of sulforaphane in broccoli. You do not increase the levels of either sulforaphane or glucoraphanin by a cooking method whatsoever. You may enhance it, you may retard its destruction, you may retard its loss or limit its loss. But the other thing is, they have a couple of figures in that paper that suggest, and you know, I should talk to the authors perhaps and take my beef to them, but they suggest that the controls have far less glucoraphanin in them than the treatments, the different microwave times. That can't be so. It's impossible. I promise you that you don't create glucoraphanin out of whole cloth. You don't magically create it. So I'm not very there. There's enough that worries me about that paper that I would sort of steer clear of it and just say, yeah, indeed, microwaving. If you're going to cook broccoli, microwaving is probably the best way to do it. Minimal microwaving. Make it nice and a little tender and soft, and minimize the leakage of compounds into the pot liquor, or else incorporate that into whatever you're eating. And that's the way I make broccoli. You know, rinse it, put it in a Corning dish, put it in the microwave until it just gets a little less crunchy, and eat it. And there's basically nothing in the bottom, and I put lemon juice on it.
I do the same thing. I microwave my broccoli, but I put mustard seed powder. And just an FYI for everyone viewing right now or listening, when that paper came out, the first thing I did was email Jed, and I was like, "What do you think of this paper?"
What did I say? I forgot.
Oh, you weren't. You were probably less PC about it to me. Okay. But thanks for your expert opinion on that. I think that can be, that is a misleading study.